with a little ghetto gospel. Those who wish to follow me, my ghetto gospel, I welcome with my hands. And the red sun sings at last into the hills of gold. And peace to this young warrior.
Dear God, I pray that you watch over us as we enter into this new destiny that we're about to partake into. We know that it's not an accident that we're all here today. We know that there's a reason for every single thing you do. And we appreciate that reason for whatever unknown reason that is. We all know that as artists and musicians and writers and beat makers or whatever it is you do, that you have the power to influence somebody through your music. I pray that no one here forgets how powerful that is. I pray that you watch over us throughout our journey and that we continue to stay on your path. Thank you, Lord, for everything that you've done for us and the things that you continue to do. Amen.
What's up? It's your boy Carl Anthony. It's Saturday. Second day we're here at the competition. We made it out to the Tupac Center. We're here, we're just gonna learn a little bit, do some praying, do some educating, and then later on we're gonna go to the studio and get those songs in, so y'all stay tuned.
Ghetto gospel, I welcome with my hands. And the red sun sings last into the hills of gold. And peace to this young warrior without the sound of guns.
Got some great poems like Family Tree, Rose of Roof and Concrete, and The Event of My Demise. Who thinks about that when they're age 15? You know what I'm saying?
Some say the blacker the better, the sweeter the juice. I say the darker the flesh and the deeper the roots. I give a holler to my sister's own welfare. Tupac cares if don't nobody else care.
Tupac is the highest hip-hop selling artist, living or dead.
Please don't cry, dry your eyes, never let up. Forgive but don't forget, girl, keep your head up. And when he tells you you ain't nothing, don't believe him. And if he can't learn to love you, you should leave him. Cause sister, you don't need him. And I ain't trying to gas you up, I just call him how I see. You know what makes me unhappy? That when brothers make babies and leave a young mother to be a pastor. And since we all came from a
only God can judge me.
That right. Took the opportunity to meditate on it and ask myself, what kind of universal message can I bring to the people where the prayer isn't just a wish to the sky? I hope that God answers our prayers. Upon my meditation, I realized that, okay, maybe I should let Pac do the talking. You know what I'm saying? I came across something years ago which Pac left for us that a lot of people just don't know about. I looked for it on the internet, I couldn't find it. I looked for it everywhere, I couldn't find it. So I had to figure out where I left it at. I figured out where I left it at, went and grabbed it, and it was Tupac's last prayer to the streets. You know what I'm saying? So we're gonna start with that. This is called The Code of the Thug Life. And he wrote this, this was inspired by Mutulu Shakur. Alright? Pac said, someone must dare to put the street life back on track. It's clear to anybody that can see that the hustling game has gone stark raving mad. The short and long range result will not only be detrimental to the street game, but will also destroy any foundation in our community. But more important, the combination of self-destruction and turf warfare, coupled with the government's police terrorism, fascist laws designed to capture and keep our black men and women in jail for the rest of their lives, and leaves a defenseless community, will result in our genocide. For as long as the street game, the hustle game has existed in our community, which is the result of many factors and will only be resolved through our liberation. The dynamics of struggle between the do-gooders and the thugs has kept a consistent battle for balance in our community, which at least was under control. The game today as it exists is a complete violation of the code. Historically, the street hustler was hip to the enemy and would never work in the government's interest to destroy their own life. Let me stop right there. Rick Ross has a quote in his song right now that says, I'm selling dope on my iPhone. I'm gonna let y'all take a moment to think about that in relation to what Pac just said. Historically, the street hustler was hip to the enemy and would never work in the government's interest to destroy their own people. The thug life is a tool of the enemy as it exists today. It must change. Outside forces and methods whose interests are being served by the hustlers, the crew have no dignity. They have no honor, and this must be corrected. It's up to y'all to correct that, man. A council must be called to put a code to the thug life. We accept that the game will go on until our liberation. What we won't accept is that the game will destroy us from within before we get another chance to rumble and rebuild. If you ready to rumble and you ready to rebuild, put your hand in the air, man. The forces, in an attempt to put the game back on track and work in the interest of the community and to resist the strategy of the government, they have begun setting down a platform for the street game in full effect. We praise their efforts. The code of the thug life must become a part of us on the East Coast as well. There must be a common denominator. The original gangsters behind the walls of the dungeon will take some responsibility to put in force to the council and the code. We must act now. The code of the thug life will save us to fight another day. If we don't, we assed out. Words from Tupac Shakur.
We made it in the State Codia Studios. That's Outkast Studio for those who don't know.
Come on.
I see no changes. Wake up in the morning and I ask myself, is life worth living? Should I blast myself? I'm tired of being poor and even worse, I'm black. My stomach hurts, so I'm looking for a purse to snatch. Cops give a damn about a heat, bro.
Oh, is it over?
That's just the way it is. Things will never be the same. That's just the way it is. Oh yeah.